I'm already picturing myself as to what I would look like if I was buff. This is awesome. His neck is so big, my goodness. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to get ripped by using Photoshop. So without further ado, let's get started. All right, so as you can see, I am not the most ripped person on YouTube by any means, and that is okay because we have Photoshop. So we can Photoshop ourselves on someone that is ripped to make ourselves look ripped. Isn't that the beautiful thing about Photoshop? We love that. You guys, step by step on how to do that right now. So, first step, get someone that looks buff.
Wow.
Whether it's your cousin, your uncle, your friend, Google, whoever it is, find someone that looks buff, okay? Next, put that buff person into Photoshop, like so. Then what you need to do is, if you want to make yourself look buff or someone else look buff, get a picture of their face. All right, so in this case, you know, I have to do it. I gotta make myself look buff. So I'm gonna pick a picture of myself right now. And let's see, I'm gonna pick this picture right here. So I'm just dragging this in. And this is the picture I'm gonna use to make myself look ripped. All right, so here's what we need to do. Basically, we need to, step one, size it up so that our head is not tiny, but the same size as this guy's massive head, okay? So we need to increase the size, and you can use any buff guy for this. You know, let's not discriminate here. Any buff guy you see, feel free to use. All right. And this guy, he has a massive, like, just, he's chiseled. Okay. This is ridiculous. So I'm just going to make my head this big, and I think I like that. So let's hit enter. Then let's lower the opacity down a little bit so we can see what we're working with here. All right, I'll try to line up my eyes with his, and we'll just scoot that down a little bit. All right, and some might say that I'm already seeing it come to life. I'm just kidding. Okay, now hit enter and increase the opacity back up just ever so slightly. It's kind of creepy, I'm not gonna lie. And now what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a layer mask right down here, and then get our brush out, switch it to black, and start getting rid of anything that should not be our head. Okay, we're gonna get rid of this like so. This is awesome. And there we go. Awesome. And let's see. Okay, probably we're not gonna need our neck. Okay, let's be real. Look at this guy's neck. We want that neck. Okay, we don't want this neck. No. We're gonna be buff, so we can't have a thin neck, okay? All right, we can zoom in a little bit. Actually, get rid of this so it's not as distracting. And let's see here. This is already taking shape, which is awesome. Now, if you don't have your background already removed from your image, Photoshop does that. So make sure to check out this video right here to see it. But if you already have your background removed and you're on the step that I need to do, you're in the right place. All right. Oh my goodness, my head is too tiny for this man's body. Okay, we need to make it slightly larger, bring it down a bit, maybe. Wow, I'm already picturing myself as to what I would look like if I was buff. This is awesome. Okay, next what we need to do is get rid of this guy's head because we don't want his head anymore. Okay, we're putting our head in there. So get rid of this lock, throw that sucker in the garbage.
Linda.
And I'm going to actually go to the stamp tool, okay? And we're gonna increase the size of this brush, Alt, and we're just gonna start, let me increase this opacity and the flow. We're gonna start, you know, getting rid of this guy's head this way, okay? Wow, this is very creepy, okay? And you could just use like a brush if you wanted to. Okay, I'm gonna have to undo a little bit. Getting rid of his face like so. All right, awesome. Now, let's bring back our face. Where's our face? Oh, our opacity is zero, that's why. Bam, there's our face, awesome. Okay, so let's tilt our head a little bit because we're a meathead. We gotta tilt it, bring it down. Does it still look like my head is too small for this man's body? My goodness, jeez. How big is this guy's head? My goodness, jeez. All right, let's get it like so. All right, so I'm just realizing this guy kind of has a long neck. My goodness, okay. This is strange, okay? I don't know how many times I'm gonna do this again. Let's rotate this sucker a little bit by we'll go with that for now, all right? And now let's duplicate this layer, hide this one just in case we mess up. Now let's go to image, adjustments, vibrance. Okay, this guy's got an awesome tan going on and some tattoos, and we need to kind of match his level of tanness. So let's try, and we're getting there slowly. All right, that looks good. Now let's go back here to adjustments and color balance. So we need to make ourselves kind of look more tan. Is this actually starting to look legit? Let me know in the comments. You just kind of have to play around with it until you get something that's going to match. Oh my god, I keep looking at this and I'm like, this can't be happening. I feel like we still could blend it in slightly more. So let's go up here to image again. Brightness and contrast. Oh, there we go. Okay, that was... All right, let's go with that. We're just going for it, okay? Exposure, sure, let's see what that will do. Actually, let's cancel that. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna airbrush myself with his skin tone, okay?
That's weird.
All right, let's get this down and let's do something like this. All right, and lower this a lot. Let's get more of his skin tone up in here. So maybe that right there. Okay, that's starting to work a little bit. Does that look legit, you guys? What do you think? I feel like we could do better. Let's see. What else can we do? That's usually the most I'll do. You can try shadows. I would say that's a success, okay? Would you guys believe that? Let me know in the comments down below. Does that look legit? I don't know. Do I need to make my head bigger? Like, what's going on here? Oh my god, now I just look ridiculous. All right, let's maybe decrease the head size a little bit. His neck is so big, my goodness. That's like the weirdest part of it that I can't get over is his neck. Like, his neck is massive. I'm over here like thinking like, did I do something wrong? All right, I think that's good enough, at least for what we're trying to achieve here. Like this video if you want me to make this my profile pic.
Yes.
All right, so that is how you can put yourself on a buff person in just a few minutes. I hope you guys did find this video entertaining. I'm not sure how many times you're gonna need to do this in life, but I'm glad I was here to help if you did need this tutorial for some dire needs, so you are welcome. If you guys did like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and if you could subscribe, I would greatly appreciate the support. Also, if you are interested in learning all things about PowerPoint, even though I know this was a Photoshop tutorial, I do have a course on Udemy, so I have a link to that in the description below. Without further ado, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day, and I hope to see you guys in future videos. Thanks.